It's the new year, and you know what they say, in with the new and out with the old people, or something like that. New year, new me. Or better yet, you all can just be me, because who wouldn't want to be me? Some might say I'm a narcissist, but if you switch the letters around in narcissism, it makes sick trains, and who wouldn't want to own a train?
You heard that right, it's the new year, and here's a story brought to you by Zydee and Jaquel.
What's a New Year's resolution that never works out?
Eating less carbs.
Something that you do on New Year's?
I like to watch the New York City ball drop.
And what's a New Year's resolution or goal that you have this year?
Always to be happier. Wanting to do and finish my house. Mm-hmm. I've been remodeling that, so I want to be done with that so I can just enjoy it and not have to do house projects.
And are you going anywhere for New Year's?
I'm going to the Bahamas.
What's something fun you're gonna do?
I'm gonna swim with pigs.
Yeah. What? Do you have a favorite cider that you drink during New Year's?
Apple cider.
Oh my.
No.
So do you have any New Year's resolutions this year?
Yeah, make it through the ACT and just have a relaxing summer.
Speaking of summer, here's a story on Swim Team by Charlie and Jerem.
You're one of the best on the team. How do you feel about that?
It's nice to be fast, but it's all a team effort.
How long have you been swimming?
I've been swimming about 6 years. So.
6 years, huh?
Yeah. No, not a young lad out here.
We heard you have some pretty big plans after high school, is that correct?
I do have some pretty big plans. I'm trying to get into the Navy Academy, and I'm being recruited by a few colleges right now. Right now, I'm the third fastest in the state.
The third?
Yeah.
Out of like everyone?
Out of everybody.
The sets are always really hard and practice is always like crazy hard, but it's super fun because you get to hang out with like your best friends.
And how are we doing overall in the season?
Well, we started out our season with our district opener and we won that. And so I'm expecting us to be region champions this year.
Sounds great. Like to be on the swim team for Mountain Ridge?
It's a lot of hard work and dedication. It's like that one rock song, you put in the hours, it's like that. Yeah,
so every day we get in, we do a warm-up, we do a lot of kicking with kickboards, stuff like that, and then we do a lot of sprinting, diving off the blocks, working on our flip turns.
Thanks for tuning in, Mountain Ridge.
Hello Mountain Ridge, I'm Sam Rivera and I'm here with Private Ward, who has recently joined the Army, and we are about to find out why. Why did you join the Army?
Just to keep America safe and make sure to do my part in the world.
The Army is something I always wanted to do, and I watched my uncle fly helicopters, and since then I've wanted to be in the military.
I joined the military because I wanted to follow tradition with my family.
Why did you choose the Army?
They take care of your military side, and then when you get out, they make sure that you're all set for your civilian side again.
They have a lot more benefits, and they'll help me go to where I want to be in life.
Who was the biggest supporter?
Of course, my family, but Sergeant Melendez, that was my recruiter.
My friend, and he was actually like an uncle to me, he passed away, and while we were at his funeral, they had a picture of him as a airborne paratrooper. But if he became such a great man while he was being in the military, I was thinking that I wanted to follow the same path.
How are you liking the military so far?
Honestly, I'm actually like happy I joined. It's a lot easier for college. I've met a lot of cool people in the military. But right now, the military is paying 100% of my tuition, and all I'm paying is student fees.
What is like the career path that you're choosing in the Army?
So it's called a 91 Bravo. It's just a wheel vehicle mechanic, heavy and lightweight. So if it has wheels, I'll be up and underneath it, yeah, working on it.
Awesome. What's the process to join?
So you have to take the ASVAB, which is just like a test to get into the military. And then the physical, and a bunch of signing papers. Your hand will hurt by the end of the day, for sure.
Thank you for your service.
Well, hi, Carly. Welcome to the set.
Hey.
What can you tell us about rugby?
Well, we're looking for anyone who's interested. All is welcome. And we have a team meeting on the 12th from 6 to 8 at the lecture hall here at the school. And then we also are having a winter camp, which is going to be at the RCL Soccer Center. And we're just trying to teach you guys about rugby and see what you're interested in and what your ability is from a forward to a back. And we're looking for anyone. So, yeah.
Awesome.
So you should definitely join rugby. It's fun. And we're also going to possibly go into Florida for spring break and possibly Ireland after the end of the year. So.
That sounds super cool. You guys should try out for rugby.
And if y'all have any questions, just go to Laura Kubler's room in the orange hall, please.
Awesome.
Wood shop is a great way to learn new things and make new friends.
Our own Miss Vaudrey once made a rocking chair.
Hey there, Sentinels. Today, we're here in the wood shop. First question, how do you like the class?
I love it, man. It's really cool.
My favorite part of this class is the community and the friends that I make and the freedom in the wood shop and woodworking itself.
Nice. What's your favorite project that you've made or are currently making in this class?
Last year I actually made a hammock made completely out of wood.
Well, I'm making the rocking chair right now, and it's just really cool because I'm stoked to have it to just give it to some of my family members when I'm done.
Nice. For any students who are coming into the school or haven't taken this class, would you recommend them taking this class?
Absolutely. 100% take this class.
Even if you're like a senior next year, just still take the class. It's really rewarding.
So, Mr. Miner, what's your favorite part about teaching this class?
I love when a student built a project that they didn't think they could build, and when they get it done, and you see the light in their eyes just go, wow, I did that. I love that. That's cool.
Yep. And how long have you been working with wood, being a craftsman?
Well, I've taught in January. I will have taught for 32 years, so that's a long time. But I've been working with wood and building stuff since I was probably six, seven years old. So really long time.
Nice. And with all that experience you've had, what is your favorite thing to make?
I love making spoons. I love making stools and I love making chairs. Those are my favorite things to make.
Nice.
These talkies are hot.
Just like our drill team.
Don't even finish that sentence.
So, I'm Maddie Jones and I'm like in charge of a certain routine, which is POM, and in charge of just like the new girls asking if they're okay and social media.
My name is Soraya Gertzen. I'm in charge of dance, and my job is motivational, and I kind of prepare motivation before comp season, and each comp I do like a little like motivation for the team.
I'm Abby Jarmillo. I'm also just a captain on the team. I'm in charge of our show routine, and I'm over like the alternates and the dances just to make sure like they don't have any questions. I'm in charge of birthdays and
I'm Riley Peterson, I'm also a captain, and I'm in charge of the military routine, and then I'm also in charge of like the team's appearance, so I do like makeup, costumes, things like that.
It's so fun to be with all the girls, and like it is just a big family, and like everyone loves each other, and our coaches are so nice, like they're the best coaches.
And you gain so many friendships, and the coaches, like everyone said, they're seriously the sweetest and they will help you achieve so many of your goals and you learn so many life lessons that you will use for the rest of your life. 'Cause I got a feeling you're coming back just like you have in the past. Yeah, I got a feeling you'll be sending me trash. You should have left in the tracks. Yeah, I got a feeling you'll see me.
Another sport is boys wrestling.
And what's up a little bit wrestling footy men?
more than just a monster stammer.
Like, obviously our kids that are more experienced did a good job. We have some kids that are a little less experienced that are new to the sport. They're still learning, so I mean, we'll get there and we'll improve.
It went all right. We had some tough matches that we lost and some tough things that happened, but overall I think a lot of guys started figuring out some stuff they needed to, and we'll be a lot better once we fill in at the weights we need to. There was a couple things I could work on. Kid did a 10-on-2 on me. I beat the kid 16-4 still though. But I have a lot of goals and want to travel nationally and do really well there, so.
I feel like I did all right. I'm still overweight by a little weight. I got a little ways to go still. But other than that, I feel like I did pretty good.
Yeah, we got great kids and a lot of new kids with a lot of potential. And so it's always fun to watch kids improve and grow and learn. Obviously they'll start off pretty green. And by the time we hit into like January and stuff, they are generally figuring out how it all works. So,
what got you into wrestling?
What got me into wrestling was I originally started out with like jujitsu, and I tried wrestling as a cross train, and so I ended up just falling in love with it, and I've been doing it ever since.
Probably what got me into wrestling, I think it's a really fun sport. I've kind of just been doing lots of sports, so I just wanted to give it a try, and it's been a lot of fun.
So what motivates you when you wrestle?
What motivates me, probably to, like, just do my best. Like, I always just want to place really high, I want to do really good, so that's what motivates me, just to do my best, you know.
For me, it's mostly about, like, just not quitting and not giving up. Like, it doesn't matter if I'm winning or losing, it just matters as long as I'm doing my best, you know what I mean? Like, not giving up, or if I'm in a bad situation, just knowing that it's not over, even if it hurts.
What are some successes you have?
My sophomore year, I took second in state, and so I decided to switch over here because they had a good wrestling program. This year, I would say my success is coming back onto the mat after dislocating my shoulder.
So how is the season going?
So far, the season's actually going pretty good. We've only had one tournament, and we had a lot of placers already, so that's pretty good.
What have you learned from wrestling?
I've actually learned a lot from wrestling. It's kind of something that made everything around me feel easier. Like, wrestling is really hard, and so when I'm like in season and stuff, just like doing little stuff outside of wrestling feels a lot easier than like when I'm not in season.
What's your goal for the meet tonight?
My goal for the duel tonight is to win against my girl, obviously, and then yeah, just have fun, learn a lot, you know, teach something, just anything like that.
I don't stop until I break a sweat. Ooh, wet. I keep dripping, hit them with finesse. Ooh, ooh, wet. Every day I wake, I know I'm blessed. Ooh, ooh, wet. Pull up like I barely hit the net. Ooh,
ooh, wet. What got you into playing basketball for the high school?
Well, my dad kind of got me into basketball, and then I just wanted to keep playing, so I played for the high school.
Yeah, I always went to like Harriman High School games as a kid, and I always just wanted to be out on the court with them, so that's always been a goal of mine.
What effects do the student section have while you're playing at home?
At home, it's super big for us, and like, you know, I think basketball is all about momentum plays, so I think when we have the students there, it's super helpful for us. Like, just helps us out a lot.
What is the pressure like when you're shooting a free throw, like at an away game or something?
It depends on the crowd, but sometimes it's pretty bad. They're all like yelling at you and trying to talk to you while you're trying to shoot.
Yeah, it gets nervous when you know all those people are watching you and kind of just yelling at you, I guess. When I was younger, there was a little more pressure, but now it's not as bad. But honestly, I would prefer to have noise than to have it dead silent. That's just my opinion. But yeah, once you get used to it, it's fine.
Wet. Every day I wake, I know I'm blessed. Ooh, ooh, wet. Pull up like I barely hit the net. Ooh, ooh, wet. I don't
don't stop until I break a sweat.
What kind of pressure do you feel when you start versus when you come off the bench?
I think starting is a little easier for me just because, you know, you just get to get rolling. But when I come off the bench, I don't feel too much pressure. It's almost like I'm excited to go in, you know. I'm always waiting to go into the game, so there's not, yeah, I don't get too nervous about it. I'm just always ready to go.
We need to address the elephant in the room, rather the dead elephant.
Thousands of elephant carcasses were found with poached tusks.
CSI is investigating the current situation.
All right, guys, I'm here with Nick. Nate. Tell us a little bit about this activity in class.
So we're just trying to find out who killed the elephant. Pretty sure it was me, but we don't know yet.
All right, well, I guess we'll find out. So tell us a little bit about what's going on.
So we are doing this. We've been doing a unit on tusklessness of elephants, trying to figure out why they are tuskless. And we're using a bunch of different methods. This is one of them, electrophoresis. So poachers are a huge problem in Africa. So we are using, so they actually use electrophoresis to match DNA sequences with tusks.
I'm going to take one of these. Get into character, guys. So by wearing all of these hats, do you think it's like going to help you figure out what's going on?
Yeah, I already figured it out. See?
Oh, can I ask what you're doing?
We're looking at the DNA sequences and we're trying to figure out which one matches up with the poacher. So, yeah.
So who do you think killed the elephant?
Nate.
All right, guys, now we're going back to the classroom to figure out who killed the elephant. All right, you guys. Everybody was right. It was Nate. All along. He's a murderer. So, as the murderer of this activity, what did you learn?
I learned that my genes matched up with the murderer, so you know what that means. I was the murderer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Cool.
Nice work, CSI. If you're into true crime
and real-world problems and how to fix them,
join CSI.
In other news,
the world according to Vegas Sci.
Have you ever wondered how the mental health is affecting schools? Imagine. Kids are so worried about their grades and their social standing that they don't care about their own mental health anymore. And that's why I'm here to help. So, we're going to go talk to students about how they are feeling about this year's mental health with the school. Come along with me and we'll find out together. Here's a hug.
What do you guys usually do to de-stress?
Listen to music or hang out with friends.
Okay.
I like to sleep.
What do you do to de-stress?
Skate.
And do you think school helps or messes with your mental health?
A little bit of both, honestly. Like, my team helps, but the stress of school doesn't help.
Okay. Do you think the social standards that us students set up messes with our mental health?
I mean, I think it can. It's hard to be kind in a highly competitive environment, but I think that's why it's all the more important to strive towards kindness. And I think that's where mental health can be either strengthened or hurt.
Question: do you think that that students' social status is something that can affect their own mental health?
I definitely do, but sometimes you just gotta ignore it and be a normal person.
And Jenna, what's something that makes your morning better?
Coffee,
okay. Do you think that status quos are affecting the mental health of students?
Yeah.
Why?
I don't know, people just overthink too much and then they just get too in their head about it and then takes a lot of energy to like get up every day and be like, oh, do I look pretty enough, or do I have enough makeup on, or like, does my outfit look like cool enough, or like whatever, like, I don't know, the standards are just too high and like people just stress out too much and overthink it too much.
So you're saying that people shouldn't overthink the stuff that they wear or the stuff that they do?
Yeah.
See, that's what I do. I basically throw on whatever's in my closet.
Stop.
So guys, if there's one thing I've learned throughout the high school experience so far, is stay positive, you know,
kindness is key. Don't care what other people say, because in the end, it doesn't matter. It matters on the memories you make. Vegas Sai signing off for the last time. See ya.
Chicago.
This has been another great broadcast brought to you by Avery
and Aiden
and the Mountain Ridge Video Association, the MVA. Rock the ridge, baby girl.
Rock the ridge.
Rock the ridge.
Okay. All right, we're done.
Whoa!
After school, Maggie is online, checking out new updates from her friends. She just found out that her best friend Jenny got a car, and her boyfriend got braces. That will be kind of weird. Then Maggie gets a message that someone she doesn't know wants to friend her. That means the person will be able to follow Maggie's updates, look at her pictures, and see her other friends. The mystery person says she's a teenage girl from Maggie's town, but Maggie is sure she's never met her. You're probably thinking, Maggie, don't do it. And you're exactly right. It's just not a good idea to friend a stranger online. Even though the mystery person claims to be another teenager, who knows? They could be a creepy dude from far away. They could be dangerous, too, and could put Maggie in an uncomfortable situation, or get private, personal information from her. Maggie's no space cadet. She thinks about these possible dangers and then rejects the mystery person's request. Instead, she sends Jenny a message about her new car. She wants a ride, like now. So how should you decide who to be friends with online? Figuring that out is pretty simple, actually. If you're friends with someone in the real world, it's okay to be friends with them online. This rule goes for all kinds of websites, chat rooms, email, text messaging, and instant messaging. And keep in mind that your favorite sites, like MySpace and Facebook, have settings that allow you to control who can and cannot see your profile, updates, videos, and pictures. Make sure you understand how to use these privacy settings so only people you know and trust have access. Think about it. You get to know your friends by hanging with them, seeing them around town, and going to school with them. You see them every day, and that's the best way to figure out who is safe and who you can trust. Maggie made the right choice when she decided not to friend someone she doesn't know in real life. When you're online, be like Maggie and keep it real. Real friends in the real world. It's the best way to stay safe and keep things awesome.